If your video previews are laggy, jerky, choppy, jumpy, or skippy, I'm going to show you a few options to fix it using PowerDirector. Let's get those jerks out of here. The first option is disabling tracks. If you have a complex timeline with a lot going on, disabling some of the tracks may allow you to preview the timeline without any lag. To disable a track, you just go to the left and you click on the little eye on the video track, and that track is now disabled. And when it plays, it'll only try to play the video on the tracks that are enabled. Therefore, it will have less work to do and you should have a smooth preview. Option numero dos is adjusting the preview resolution. When you change this, it's only adjusting the resolution you see while editing. It does not impact the final resolution when you produce the video. What you want to do is right-click your preview window, go to preview quality, and go to the preview quality that you want to use while you're editing. As you can see, the preview is more pixelated, but when you play it back, it'll be less laggy because of the lower resolution. The next option is render preview. This renders any effects, titles, transitions, or additional video layers you add to the timeline, which makes the playback smoother. You want to move your cursor to a position where you want to start the render preview. So I'm going to left click on this clip. And as you can see, I have two clips here. So maybe I want to render this out so that it plays back smoother. Then you want to place your cursor over the yellow section of the playhead until you see a yellow cursor. Hold down your left mouse button and drag that over to the position where you want the render preview to stop. Then you want to click on render preview. When it's done, you'll see a green line above the section, signaling that that is a rendered preview. If you add any new titles, effects, things like that to it, then the green line will disappear and you'll need to re-render it again. If you're finding this video useful so far, click clack that like button. It gives me an indication that I'm building an audience by creating helpful content for my viewers. Option number four is non-real-time preview. Non-real-time preview is a slower preview mode that helps you edit by reducing lag. If you right-click on your preview window and go to preview mode, you see that you have an option for a non-real-time preview. Keep in mind, once non-real-time preview mode is enabled, your audio will be muted. You need to go back to real-time preview in order to hear your audio. The last option are shadow files. Shadow files or proxy files are lower resolution versions of your clips which allow you to edit faster and with less lag. It does not impact the final resolution when you produce your video. To get the shadow files, you go to Preferences, General, and left click here where it says Enable Shadow Files. You can then select the shadow file resolution that you want to use and click on OK. If you want to keep your video file small without losing quality, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.